Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
So the UK approved this vaccine, and we will be hopefully doing it very soon. When the FDA looks at this kind of stuff, or the regulator in the UK, are they just looking at paperwork? Are they doing any kind of real studies on their own?
No. They're just looking at the paperwork being submitted by the company, by Pfizer, who there's a whole process for this. And believe me, it's very intense. When they send their approval papers in, it comes in boxes. There will be a room full of boxes, and it all has to be gone over very carefully by the FDA regulators. That's what they look at.
So are we going to be watching what happens in the UK before we start rolling it out here, or are we going to start in December, and then what's the timeline?
So the UK, they move a little faster than us. And so they got the approval out there today or yesterday. The committee that's going to review this, the FDA advisory, it's only an advisory committee to the FDA. They can do whatever they want, but they want to have the committee behind them. In the UK, they voted 13-1. But one person was against it. But so that's going to happen on December 10th. And anything can happen after that. They can just say, okay, we'll take the committee's recommendation and go with it, because they have all the information there now. They're looking at it now.
Naperville did not pass a mask mandate. What's your idea of government-mandated masks and maybe having, you know, some kind of consequence for not following through on this?
I mean, places now that don't, with the information that we have, the indisputable fact that masks help and will save people's lives. Anyone that refuses a mask mandate, I mean, this is like total incompetence. There has to be some teeth in whatever law comes out to force the mask mandate. It has to be mandated. They have to do it, because it's going to take, 6 to 9, 12 months to get the vaccine out to everybody who wants it. In the interim, how many people do we have to kill? That's what's going to happen. People will die if they don't do the mask thing.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions here. Assuming the vaccine gets rolled out as planned and is administered to a vast majority of the public by April or May, what can the public expect as far as guidelines go next summer? Will masks and social distancing be a thing of the past?
Well, I mean, ultimately, the masking and social distancing will be a thing of the past once all this goes into effect. The question is, how fast can the vaccine be rolled out? Vaccines be rolled out. It is a challenge. It's a challenge just in terms of numbers. To give 250, 300 million people two doses of a vaccine, this is like, I don't know if you understand the logistics here. It's really incredible. People will go as fast as we want. A lot of people aren't going to want to take the vaccine, but if enough take it, the whole thing is going to go away.
All right, next question. Elderly people in nursing homes are at high risk of infection and have been prioritized to receive the vaccine early, but they are also medically fragile. Don't the side effects themselves pose a serious risk to them?
No, they don't really. They've looked at the high-risk populations very carefully. The Moderna and the Pfizer study very clearly show that you can safely give this to older people. Matter of fact, what they found was that the response in elderly people was actually very good. Flu vaccine doesn't have a good response in older people. Matter of fact, you have to give 4 times the regular dose of a flu shot to somebody over 65. So this is very different. This is a different kind of vaccine. It works in older people and it's safe.
Earlier this week, you told us Northwestern had a testing study going on. You're still looking for volunteers to, to get COVID tested?
Yeah, it's to get COVID tested. We do the standard test, the PCR test, the one that takes a couple days to get the results back. And we're doing a new test that only takes 15 minutes. But we have to compare the new test with the old test, the standard test. So that's how we get these newer tests approved. But everybody gets the standard test, and they get they can get a sheet with their result on it if they need it for any kind of travel or anything like that.
And there's the email address on your screen if you want to do that. Test us at northwestern.edu. Thank you, Dr. Murphy. If you have a question for the doctor, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Hey, Paul. Oh, nope. Sorry, Larry. Go ahead with the news.